Hello and welcome to today's daily market update with me, Josh Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Now we've had a number of economic events coming out this morning out of the Eurozone, and much of the focus throughout the whole beginning of the day today has been on the Eurozone. A lot of it's been roughly in line with expectations. Now in Germany we've had a better than expected consumer climate figure. However, we know that the German economy of those within the Eurozone is stronger than most. The retail sales figure came in just below expectations, but it didn't really have too much of an impact on the markets. Within Spain, we know that they're not doing too great recently, and so the fall down to 0.5 or minus 0.5 GDP growth kind of was expected. It's not actually had any sort of impact within the markets either. Now, more importantly, later in the day, we've actually had the release of the CPI. And the CPI figure, inflation figure, is important mainly because of the impact they will have on the interest rate decision on Thursday. Now, the interest rate decision on Thursday is going to be loosely based on the target that they actually have, which is a price target as opposed to a growth target. Now, within the UK, we also have a price target, and we've got inflation that's too high, around about 2.8, where we actually want around about 2%, and therefore it kind of stifles the choices within the Bank of England for them to be able to actually implement any more QE. Now, we've got the opposite problem within the ECB, where in actual fact it was at 1.7 earlier today, and they expected it to fall to around about 1.6, would give them a little bit more room to breathe in terms of a interest rate reduction. In actual fact, it fell to 1.2%, so a massive drop, and therefore, you know, it's kind of, for many of the people in the markets, it's making everyone think it's almost a foregone conclusion that we will get some sort of rate cut on Thursday, and everyone really is gearing towards that decision on Thursday. Now, it is one of a few decisions within the week, and it sort of feels like within the ECB, or within the Eurozone in particular, all of these different releases are just feeding into what that decision will be on Thursday. What is interesting about that decision on Thursday is previously we had around about just over half of the economists in a Reuters poll expecting it to be dropped from 0.75 to 0.5%, the interest rate. However, you know, that means that it's almost 50%, just above, and therefore there is some indecision. Now this 1.2% is going to impact on that. However, it's now pushing people the opposite direction, where people are thinking potentially it might even be dropped down to 0.25. And where there's that kind of indecision within the markets, it means that when the rate decision does actually come out, it does have room to actually make pretty large spikes within the price action of the likes of euro dollar and euro sterling. So watch out for that, and everyone's going to be positioning themselves for that on Thursday. Now, we're looking forward to the decision tomorrow within the Chinese economy. We're basically on the decision, but we have the manufacturing PMI rate coming out tomorrow, and that's always got a large impact because it is such a massive economy and it has a large impact upon Australia in particular and those commodity currencies. So look towards that tomorrow. And again, we've got the non-farm payrolls on Friday, so that's another major one to look forward to. So a lot of it's going to be geared towards some of these bigger decisions later on in the week. Now, if we take a look at some of the charts now, first and foremost, I want to take a look at the euro dollar chart, mainly because of the fact that we've got some large data coming out of there today, and much of the focus is on that. Now, it looks like we've basically taken on a head and shoulders formation since the back end of 2012, and it looks like we're coming to the top of the right shoulder of this, and therefore it would mean that I'm pretty bearish on the pair down to around about that 1.274. Now, obviously, it's going to be impacted largely by that decision on Thursday, so that brings some more uncertainty to it. However, when you look at the CCI and the stochastic indicators, they're both pushing towards overbought, and therefore I'd expect there to be some sort of move to the downside. Now, also, if you look just above where we are at the moment, we've got that 100-day moving average, which would likely provide some form of resistance as well. So even if we do get some sort of upside, I'd expect it to find some sort of resistance around about that point. Now, if we take a look over at the cable chart, I mean, basically, we've had a pretty strong period recently off the back of that GDP figure the other day, but it looks like it's slowing down somewhat. That doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to stop the move northwards, because what is kind of relevant here is the fact that we've pushed through that 1.535 mark, which was actually a range that it was trading within for a really long period of time. So to push back into that range means that we might actually start ranging back up towards that 1.63 area, and therefore some sort of consolidation, or maybe a push back towards that 1.535 to test it as newfound support, is slightly expected. So if we look at the CCI and the stochastic, again, both of those are overbought. So we may see some sort of movement to the downside over the coming days. But that doesn't necessarily mean that I'm bearish on the pair, because the overall emphasis now, I believe, is going to be bullish. So that's it for today, guys. And if you want any more news and analysis, come and check out the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom, or check me out on Twitter. My name is Joshua Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Have a great day.